the best that we can do is to try our hardest to make sure that every child can be as normal as possible, able to play with their friends, able to go to school, and able to be as happy as possible, given the constraints of whatever medical problem that they have. There are many specific congenital anomalies that we treat. Some of them are common, though many of them are not common. Hydrocephalus is the Greek word for too much fluid in the brain. The brain makes fluid and allows it to circulate around the brain and into the spine. We're getting closer and closer to being able to make the fluid either not be made or made in a way that we can control. Another congenital anomaly that we treat is called Chiari malformation. This is an anomaly that is relatively common, where in fact the brain seems to be quite big and the bones around it seem to be quite small. We have an operation that we do for that, where we enlarge part of the head by removing some of the bone. We're in a situation now where we can see the Chiari malformation well and follow it, and sometimes the children actually grow out of it. Or in fact, they don't have any symptoms, and so we generally leave them alone. But that decision is one that takes quite a bit of evaluation and quite a bit of discussion with the family of a child who has this, because there are certainly difficulties that can arise. Another congenital anomaly is something called a syrinx. That's a Greek word meaning that the fluid that's building up inside the spinal cord will cause a problem with the spinal cord and stretch it until the spinal cord begins to malfunction. We have a variety of ways to place some sort of drainage tube so that the fluid can actually mix from inside the spinal cord to end up outside the spinal cord where it can be reabsorbed. Another congenital anomaly that occurs in the spine is what we call spina bifida. The bones in the spine have opened up, usually in the back part of the bones, and leave spaces in between. As we look deeper and deeper into the spine, we find that there's other problems that are beneath the abnormal bones, especially what we call a tethered spinal cord, where the spinal cord somehow scarred to the bottom of the spine. And as the child grows, the spinal cord itself doesn't move upwards towards the head, as is the usual, but ends up being stretched out. Fortunately, that can also be fixed by a surgery that releases the spinal cord from the bottom of the spine, allowing it to move freely. There are certainly congenital anomalies that occur in the skull. One of those problems is something called craniosynostosis, which is a Greek rendition of when the bones of the skull knit together too soon. And so the parts of this skull that should be growing stop growing, and the brain finds itself in sort of a problem of how to allow the brain to be as big as it needs to. There is a very complicated congenital anomaly called Myelomeningocele. It's when a child is born where the spinal cord is somehow tethered to the bottom of the spine all the way to the anal fissure. We find these children because oftentimes the skin and the bones in the bottom of the spine didn't grow appropriately, and the children are born actually with a hole in the bottom of their spine. Fortunately, the ability to close the hole before the baby comes out of the mother has made this a lot safer. And many of those children do get function that they otherwise would not have gotten. There are also other congenital anomalies that are very rare. Those are anomalies of the skull that force the skull to overgrow, and the brain continues to get somewhat compressed. The bone grows inward just as much as it grows outward. That's a very difficult problem. Fortunately, for many of the children who have that kind of congenital anomaly, there's a point where they become adults, and in fact, the bony overgrowth slows down and oftentimes stops. There's also medication that can be used to slow down the growth of the bone. We treat almost every congenital anomaly that we bump into. That's really what we're here for.